decision, if I am capable of bringing the same thing into practical implementation, that siddhi, that practicality, as well as dexterity or accomplishment skill is known as cognitive technology. The second type of cognitive technology is instrumental. First type of cognitive technology is internal. For example, if I want to achieve something without the aid of anybody, I can make that. That is known as independent internal cognitive technology. Second thing is external dependent cognitive technology is the interactive studies of cognition with modern technology. Cognition plus modern technology is known as cognitive technology. That is considering the cognitive psychology, various other forms of waves, phrases, impulses, emotions, balances and imprints of the inner mind, they are read in cognitive psychology. Whatever you are having it inside, applying the same thing for a common purpose or for an achievement with the help of technology is known as cognitive technology. And this is the technology which is emerging now, and the emergence of the technology as well as the convergence of the technology today we are going to discuss. So this is the real cognitive technology in which the impulses of the mind, they are read with the other properties of modern science and modern technology. What is modern technology? It has storage facilities, it has processing facilities, it has acquisition facilities, it has translation facilities, it has memory facilities, it has communication and distribution facilities, and it has compression facilities by which greater things can be compressed to a micro level, and it has expansion facilities, retrieval facilities, propagation facilities, cryptic facilities, decoding facilities. Innumerable facilities are there in technology which are nothing but the reflections of human technology. The internal technology, whatever we are doing, the same thing is done by technology for mass reach, rapid performance and more precision, simultaneous handling. These four things are the specialties of the technology. You can do the same thing. You can do the same thing which the technology is doing, but the time factor, the energy factor, the risk factor, or the precision or the value factors, these four factors are different from an independent operation from the technical operation. Somebody told that now it is a new technology. It is very funny to imagine that cognitive technology is new, because without having the cognitive skill, how they have founded this nanotechnology, information technology, and biotechnology? Biotechnology, did it evolve by itself? Cognitive technology, we are all latecomers to cognitive technology. So there are two ways of approach. A person, that's what I told, the difference between Eastern and Western system of understanding is they should try for basics in West. They will try with basics in the East. That is a major difference I told in a seminar. We have the ontology, axiology, epistemology and teleology for anything. Now ontology is a new subject. Nobody knows what is ontology. They will ask for apology that they don't know that. So having, that's what I told on that day, 108 differences between East and West. The first difference is Western learning that tries for foundation, whereas Eastern learning that tries with foundation. So cognitive learning in all Eastern treatises, you start, it will start with pratyaksha, anumana, shabda, nirupana. What is perception? What is analytical probability? What is the theory of proportionate logic, possibilistic logic, intuitionistic logic? What is environmental degradation? And what is environmental inculcation? What is the eco-responsive factor of mind? And what is the psychoanalysis of ecology, socio-psychology, eco-psychology, eco-sociology, eco-physiology, innumerable varieties of these things. They have just analyzed in their treatises. That is the greatness of Eastern way of wisdom. But there is a gap between, or a bridge that is to be constructed between these two people. They have done with all the derivatives, seeking for fundamentals. These people being totally packed within the analysis of the primordial factors, further extension towards interpretation towards the modern, contemporary and futuristic trends, that is lacking there. So somebody should build a bridge, a non-controversial bridge or setu between these two traditional and technical sciences. So the purpose of cognitive technology is to understand everything in the real format. And which has come now, see, there are two things. One is understanding things because of their greatness. Understanding things that we think. We produce lot of things. The things produced by us is not the product of our thought. Our thought is different, the product is different. So the product that has enhanced me to think of something by which I can assemble a product. The assembly is a material assembly. So a material assembly has been provoked by a non-material or a paramaterial internal organ by which I have contemplated. If my product is great, then that produce has been produced by a basic thought that must be greater. That was the greater contemplative system of our system, our traditional learning, in which they thought, if I can make anything out of my knowledge, more than the things that I have made, the instinct or that energy that has contributed for all of this making, certainly it should be greater. What is that? So there are some type of deviations that occurred in both of these scientific communities. One community, they thought, yes, I am making everything, I am seeing everything. If I can analyze everything, then instead of considering the things which are subjected to analysis, the analytical standard of my mind or any tool, that must be greater. Let me analyze that. Let me analyze the tool that has facilitated me to analyze everything. So this is Indian knowledge system. Second thing is, I have analyzed a lot of things. How I can further analyze them, further go into the unexplored regions of the unfathomable abysmal core of those things, into nanoparticles, femtoparticles, picoparticles, how I can go further, deeper. So this thing are two things. One is known as deeper drill. Second is known as wider drill. So deeper drill, or the deeper cognitive drill of the Indian systems, they started with, if I have understood everything by mind, what is behind the mind? What is behind the intellect? What is behind the consciousness? It is a deeper drill. If I have understood this thing, then what is the next? What is the next? Going in a wider dimension is modern science. So cognitive technology as per modern science is the application of the mind instincts in the form of parallel computation technical exercises with the present technologies available for understanding the structure of operations, number one. Number two, to design the structure of operations and also to verify the operations and to promote them in higher standards or more richer standards. So this is known as cognition technology. And now cognition technology means how to get support from tools, how to get it from technologies, latest inventions. There is one Israeli company which is known as Cognifit. Now latest research, they have made lot of softwares. You know that there are lot of softwares now available for language, speech recognition, for translation, transcription softwares are there. Likewise, cognitive training software. It is known as cognitive training software. And what is the use of that? Like speech recognition software like Dragon and other things, they, when applied with the persons, if you are operating that, you have to give the inputs, then it will easily evaluate whatever the gurus they were doing there. Now it is done by softwares. An acharya, a spiritual preceptor, or a capable teacher, instructor, he should evaluate. Perhaps he don't know how to evaluate, as he has not been evaluated at the time of his instruction. So now this thing is not there. So it is customized. Cognifit software is a customized software. Whenever just a speech recognition customized software is there, if you start applying, it will ask for a lot of personalized inputs. That is known as cognitive details. What is your nutritional value and what is your physical status? What is your vulnerability to various other environmental disasters and congestions? What is the status of your memory? What is the status of your repatriation? What is your shock absorption level? What is your mind suspension level? What is your sturdity? What is your robust way of thinking? How strong is your cognitive construction? All of these intellectual details are taken as inputs.